everyone, welcome to Botany Insider, and in this lecture I'll be pointing out the various mistakes that we tend to make during the preparation, or the mistakes that we should avoid during our preparation so that we can make our preparation the best and have a short aim for our success. So the most common mistake that most of us make is that not having the hard copy of the syllabus. We have the syllabus copy in our phone or somewhere else and not having it in our hand. So what happens is that when we do not have the hard copy of the syllabus and we keep it in the phone itself, so we feel lethargic while completing any topic. That is, when we have completed any topic, we do not take the courage to open our phones and tick mark over there, which is not possible. Hence, it is very important for us to have the hard copy of the syllabus so that you can track the syllabus, where your preparation is going, so that you can have a clear cut understanding that okay, these many topics are complete, these are the topics I have to focus, and these many topics are left. For that, having a hard copy of the syllabus is very important. This mistake might sound very weird, but trust me, this change in your preparation strategy can change the game. So make sure that you have a hard copy of your syllabus. The next very common mistake that we tend to make is that we try to cover the entire syllabus. Logically, if we see, there is no point in covering all the 13 units. Why? Because it is not needed for us to cover. But many of us tend to make this mistake that we try to cover the entire syllabus. No. Instead of that, what you should do is you should focus upon the important units, the important topic. And which are the important units? I'll be explaining about all those important units in the next video separately. So, instead of trying to cover the entire syllabus, avoid this and try to focus upon the important units and the important topics as well. The next mistake that we tend to make is that we do not plan our preparation. Remember, no planning means no success. This is very, very important that you plan out every day, plan out every month. I have made a separate video about how to manage your time. So do not take planning lightly. Having a solid proof plan would help you get through this examination very easily. For me, clearing this examination, the most important thing that played role was, the first thing was planning. I planned out every single day. So make sure you plan. So make sure you avoid this mistake of not planning out your days and months. Without planning, you cannot do anything. You would end up in wasting your time, which you could give up in your studies. So make sure that you plan out your days and months very nicely for a better preparation of this examination. The next very common mistake that we tend to make is not making our own notes. What most of us tends to do is that we try to mug up all the things from the ready-made notes. That is, we go to the market and buy some of the notes. No, please don't do these things, because making notes on your own helps you to understand better, helps you to make connections better. Notes from the market would give you all the information, but they would not provide you the linkage. You would end up in reading them like a book. Instead of that, try to make your own notes. And how you should make notes, I have made a video for the same itself. I'll put the links of the same in the description box. So try to make your own notes effectively and efficiently, and do not go for just the ready-made notes. You can go for the ready-made notes if you do not find any topic anywhere, for some topics, but not for every topic. Do not go and buy a 200 pages book and keep it in your desk. Instead of that, make your own notes. That would help you much better. That would give you a much better perspective for this examination. The next common mistake that we tend to make is that we try to cover every topic with utmost perfection. That is, for example, if you are dealing with cell cycle, let's say. So most of us make this mistake that we try to cover this complete topic from first length to the last length. No, that is not required. You need not to be a perfectionist of every topic. You need to have the understanding. You need to remember those points that are required for the examination. You do not have to write a PhD thesis on cell cycle. Do not unnecessarily waste time on topics for getting utmost perfection. They would end up in wasting your time. They would end up in eating up your time like anything. So try to avoid this mistake of going for every topic and try to cover them with the utmost perfection. That is not required for this examination. Understand this examination and you'll be able to clear this examination very easily. Next is no revision plan. It resembles the same as we have just discussed, that there is no planning. There is no planning for the topics to cover, and there is no planning that when you would be starting off your revision. If you have no planning, you would end up wasting your time. I am repeating the points, but I want to insist upon revision specifically, because revision is a game changer. If you revise well, you would end up in getting through this examination. Even if you complete your syllabus from length to length and you do not revise or you do not have a revision plan, trust me, if no revision is done, you won't be able to remember anything. I personally did at least 8 revisions of all the topics that I studied, because in my mind, I was clear that even if I study 5 topics from a unit, I should revise or I should remember these topics on the last day of my examination. That is what is required. You need not to show it to someone that you have completed 100 topics and at the end of the exam, you do not remember any single topic. Instead, even if you do only 5 topics from any unit, make sure that you have a plan for revising these topics, because revision is a game changer. Revision is something that will help you to get through this examination. So try to avoid this mistake and have a complete solid proof revision plan for the preparation. The next is that you all solve the previous year question, but do not understand that why we are solving them. You have the previous year questions book and you're just solving those questions, but you're not understanding why you are solving them. Previous year questions helps us to understand the nature of the exam. They help us to understand how to read the examiner's mind. It helps us to understand that what the examiners is actually would be demanding from us in our examination. So previous year question solving is important. With or in addition to that, you should also understand that why you are solving them. So try to avoid this mistake as well holds. And with this, we are done with this particular video. I hope these informative videos are helping you in some way or the other. If yes, do let me know in the comment sections below. So thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, please do like, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel. I'll be coming up with more informative videos very soon. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.